The Inspector General of Government, IGG Betty Kamia, has revealed that only 2.3 billion shillings was recovered from corrupt individuals between January and June 2024 out of the 15.7 billion shillings recommended for recovery. Kamia made the revelation while handing over the biannual performance report. She lamented the staggering 10 trillion shillings lost annually to corruption, which accounts for over 44% of Uganda's annual revenue collections.
We investigate what we receive from the public. We call upon the public to give us more information. I have told the public, you are the people out there who know how public servants live their lives or spend public money. So bring, share with us that information.
Speaker of Parliament Anita Among urged the IGG to strengthen relationships with Ugandans and increase public awareness campaigns to combat corruption. She appealed while receiving the biannual performance report revealing Kamia's disclosure of a rise in complaints filed. Speaker Anita, who lauded the IGG team for their hard work and dedication, pledged Parliament's commitment to support the inspectorate to improve their budget and efficiency and the need to transform their work into digital capabilities.
In terms of budgetary requirement, I've just had your analog. I think you're one of the institutions that is analog. And it would be good if you went digital for you to do an audit trail to find out what is happening in all other centers of yours. So it is one of the things that chairperson you should consider looking at. And the issue of them having their own home.
The reports will be laid in the House and transmitted to the Committee of Legal and Parliamentary Affairs for further scrutiny. The murder trial of businessman Henry Katanga yesterday saw its ninth prosecution witness testify before the court, which was presided over by High Court Judge Isaac Mwata. After a month-long cross-examination of Police Director of Forensics Andrew Mubiru Kizimula, the prosecution called Katanga's 65-year-old elder sister, Naomi Nyangweso, to the stand. While she was speaking in her native Runyankore, Nyangweso revealed that Katanga had long been suspicious of his wife's actions. Her testimony paints a complex picture of family conflict, betrayal, and suspicions that preceded Katanga's death.
She was in Bugorobi at her home. Preparing myself since I had an appointment with him. After preparations, they took the body inside and laid it on the bed and then allowed us to enter inside.
Nyangweso revealed the fateful events of November 2nd, 2023, when she received a phone call from the family's houseboy, George Amanyire, alerting her to a heated altercation between Katanga and his wife, Molly.
George Amanyire, yantiresum.
As I was preparing myself, George Amanyire called me on phone.
Yantirangu, unagurultaro.
Nyangweso claimed her brother had confided in her and even entrusted her with a safe containing important documents such as land titles and business records. She also disclosed that just before his death, Katanga had plans to meet his lawyer, Ronald Mugabe Ruranga, to finalize his will. As the trial progresses, the court will be left to weigh the testimonies and determine whether Katanga's death was a result of domestic strife or a calculated crime. For now, the prosecution's case continues to unfold, with more witnesses expected to testify in the coming weeks. During a press briefing in Geneva yesterday, the World Health Organization chief Tedros Adhanom Ghebreyesus revealed that 28 health workers had been killed in Lebanon alone in the past 24 hours. The Global Health Agency will not be able to deliver a large planned shipment of trauma and medical supplies to the country on Friday due to flight restrictions, Tedros said at the same briefing.
In Lebanon, More than 1,600 people have been killed and more than 1 million displaced, including 350,000 now living in shelters and 160,000 who have crossed the border into the Syrian Arab Republic.
Lebanon's health minister said that more than 40 paramedics and firefighters had been killed by Israeli fire in 3 days, among 97 killed since Hezbollah and Israel began fighting last October.
Healthcare continues to come under attack. In Lebanon alone, 28 health workers have been killed in the last 24 hours. Many health workers are not reporting to duty as they fled the areas where they work due to bombardments.
WHO's representative in Lebanon, Dr. Abdi Nasir Abubakar, told the briefing that all of the healthcare workers killed in the past day had been on duty helping with the wounded. A total of nearly 2,000 people have been killed, including 127 children and 9,384 injured since the start of the Israeli attacks on Lebanon over the last year, the country's health ministry has said.